Hello, this is Heather Hoffman. I'm here today with a fun dimensional Christmas tag using the stitched poinsettia dies and a bunch of different Pretty Pink Posh supplies. I love the dimension you can get with those stitched poinsettias. And then I'm also using the stitched duo one for my tag base, but let's start with the flowers first. I went ahead and die cut all those layers using that watercolor paper I just showed you, the Strathmore watercolor paper. I cut two of each of the leaves and one of each of the rest of the layers. I'm gonna color these with kind of a smooshing technique with distress ink. And I've pulled an assortment of colors because I kind of want to get some variation in the colors. So I pulled out a nonstick mat. This is a silicone mat from Ranger, but anything, a clear block would work, a piece of clear acetate, whatever you have on hand. But I'm just gonna start by smooshing some of that ink on the mat, and you can put as much on. If it feels like there's just not enough there, add a little bit more. I'm starting there with spun sugar, and it doesn't show up as well in the video as some of the other colors, but it does just add a nice soft little bit of a base. And I'm purposely not trying to get complete full coverage on there. I'm just trying to get a little bit of a mottled variation, just a bit of a base color there. That's our softest color, so we're gonna keep building up after that. Our next color that we're gonna move on to is Tattered Rose. This one kind of has a little bit of a deeper, it's still a fairly soft color, but it's got a little more depth to it. So you'll start to see that color showing up on there a little more. And I'm just pressing different spots on, kind of letting the ink and the water kind of pool on there in different areas. That's how it's gonna kind of blend together to get that little bit of a watercolor effect on there as well. All right, so we've added our second color. We're gonna come on with our deepest color now, which in this case is the Worn Lipstick. And I'm trying to just be a little soft with how I put this on to start with, because I don't want this color to overwhelm all the other colors, but I want to have enough on there that it kind of blends and gives a good bit of the deeper color on there. I am going to come in with the deepest color again at the end, so I'll be able to fill in any areas, because of course right now some of those areas look a lot darker because of the amount of moisture on there. Once those dry and blend out a little bit, it's going to soften out. All right, I'm gonna set those aside and let those dry a little bit. And let's move on to the leaves. I'm gonna start with Shabby Shutters. That's a hard one to say sometimes. And this one, these leaves are smaller, so it's a little easier just to do one quick little dip there to get that base color on there. Clean that off and then grab our deeper shade, which is Peeled Paint. And I'm gonna just do the same thing, only this, I'm gonna just kind of dip one side in there and just let that be my shaded darker side on each of these. And I'm not, no particular rhyme or reason, just a little bit of random layers of color. I love the finished effect, how it's kind of a soft watercolor look when you get it all finished. All right, finally here, we're gonna move on to the very center of those poinsettias, and I'm using Fossilized Amber for this one. And these are so tiny and small, I wanted to be careful not to have too much water on there. So I just kind of put a tiny bit that I blended with my finger to be able to dip the each of those little pieces in there. All right, now that we've done all of those, let's move back and add a little bit of that deeper shade now onto the petals. Again, this is that same Worn Lipstick, and I'm just dipping in there a little more. You notice I really didn't, there's still a little moisture on the petals still. It hasn't fully dried. So I actually didn't add any water onto that. I just smooshed it on and used the water that was left on the petals. And that's gonna add a little more texture variation on there as well, because it's not gonna be quite as wet. Same thing exactly with the green as I add that Peeled Paint on there a little bit more. So that gives you, again, a little more of that variation and depth in the color. Those centerpieces are small enough, I'm not gonna add any more onto those. All right, I'm gonna grab, however, that Fossilized Amber that I used on the center, and I'm just gonna kind of blend in the corner of my tag where I'm gonna put my flowers once they're fully dry. Part of why I'm doing this, first of all, it's gonna add a little interest on that tag under the poinsettias instead of just a boring white tag. It's also gonna kind of unify these colors together, since that's the same color I have on that very top layer of the poinsettias in the center. It's gonna kind of just pull all those colors together and unify them all as one element together. All right, I like to use a little liquid glue to adhere each of these together. Just add a little dot in the center, kind of offset each of those layers of the petals as you put them on there. And once these dry, I'm gonna fluff up those petals a little bit more, but for now I'm just putting each of the layers on there just so that that can start drying and I have all those assembled together. At this point, even all my petals aren't 100% dry. There's still some moisture in that watercolor paper, but It's going to keep drying as I go along, so I'm not too worried about that. All right, now I'm going to choose a sentiment. I pulled out the Holiday Greetings stamp set. It's one of those oldie but goodie sentiment sets. And I kind of played with a few different. That peace and joy is one I always come back to a lot on this stamp set. So I was trying to see if I wanted to use a different one, but I did default back to my favorite. And it just seemed to fit tucked on that tag just right. So I'm going to pull out my Misty, line that up on there, and I'm just going to stamp this really simple in black ink. I'm using VersaFine Onyx Black. It's one of my favorite just sentiment inks when I'm not going to be coloring or anything. But I stamped that on there, and now we can start tucking. Kind of see how I played with it to make sure I liked where it was before I stamped. But now I can start fitting those leaves and the poinsettia around that sentiment. And I love how the very edge of the sentiment just barely sneaks under the bottom of that poinsettia. It kind of just adds some good movement to that as well. All right, once I had where each of those leaves were going to go under the flower, I quickly lifted off the flower, and then I could just adhere each of those leaves just at the center by just lifting them up, squeezing a little liquid glue in there, and then adhere that flower the same way with a little bit of liquid glue. I only put it in the center because, again, when this all dries, I'm going to fluff up those petals a little bit more to build on that dimension. All right, I just used a hole punch. This tag, again, was from the Stitch Duo 1 dies. It doesn't have a punch in it. I know some of the other sets do have a little hole die, so if you don't have a hole punch, I just found a hole punch was a nice, easy way to put a tab on the top there to thread some nice sheer white ribbon in there, trim the ends at an angle once I looped it through. And then there's only one thing left we need to finish this off. You can't end a pretty pink project without a little bit of sparkle and bling. So I pulled out some buttercream jewels. I'm just going to tuck a few of those around the edges of the tag. And then I also put one in the very center of that poinsettia as well, just to build on that depth a little bit. And there we go. Now I set this aside just to make sure it thoroughly dried. And now that everything's dry, the watercolor paper and the glue, I'm just going to come through with my hands and kind of curl up the edges of each of those petals. Again, that's just going to add a great bit of dimension there. As I tip it around, you'll kind of see how that made it far more dimensional than it was to begin with. All right, thanks so much for coming by today. I hope you enjoyed and have a wonderful day.